What is up, guys? Welcome back to Peb's Got the Tea. Whew. First off, I want to start out by thanking y'all. Thank y'all for always tuning in with me. Thank y'all for the support. Thank y'all for joining me today for this talk. Thank y'all for the likes, the shares, the comments. I'm getting a little more comfortable with YouTube, so you know, I'm warming up a little bit. So thank y'all for the people that, you know, have been helping me with that as well. Like, I greatly appreciate y'all. I will be posting today. So be on the lookout. I'm going to post a short where you guys can drop your name and birthday. And it's going to be like a 1 or 2 card pull of what I'm guided to tell you guys. So it's just a thank you. We're almost at 1500. I'm so freaking excited. So hit that bell, subscribe, tell your friends, tell your kids, your wives. No, not your kids, because it'd be some shit coming out. But you know, just spread the word. You know, the more that our channel grows, you know, more messages I'll be able to put out. So I greatly appreciate the support, like I said. So let's see, we're gonna hop right into it. All right, so this morning, child, I got some crazy downloads. And you know, like, I love to spend time in nature. I get a lot of my messages from nature. So crazy as fuck, I was sitting somewhere and I was thinking about something. And I just noticed that every time I have a particular thought about specific people, I see crows. And the intuitive downloads that I get about these people is no coincidence. So I had to take some notes because it was just a lot and I didn't want to forget anything. Okay, so I had seen 2 crows. First it was 1 crow and it turned into 2 crows. Then I seen a hawk. Then I had, you know, I followed the damn bird. I ain't gonna lie. I had the curiosity of a cat. So I followed the birds. It kept flying back and forth, like, between 2 trees right in front of me. So I'm like, damn, obviously it wants me to follow it. I walked towards it. It flew to another tree a little bit further down. I'm like, damn, this bird really wants me to follow it. So as I was following the bird, it just disappeared. But I came into, like, a bush, and it was, like, a bush full of fucking cardinals. So off back, 2 deaths will be significant in some of y'all life. So these deaths will represent people who have come against you and even could have tried to wish death on you. These deaths could be people that you know or people that you've heard about through other people. Whoever these individuals are, they may try to leave you something as a way to try to make up for all the wrong that they have done in your life. You'll notice a significant change in your life as whoever these people are behind the mayhem in your life, you have like a significant transformation. It's going to be a very powerful, positive transformation. As well, once these people do pass, you guys are going to start noticing your luck changing. So if you have been feeling sad, down, depressed, like you're financially stuck, all of that shit is going to be gone. Some of you are very much unaware that you've had people even practicing on you. Some of these people have been sending death spells. They've been sending conflict spells. So if you've just been having conflict with people randomly or even falling out with people that, you know, you were very close to, altercations with lovers, friends, loved ones, just random people. Yeah, they're sending that shit to you. These people have been doing crown chakra magic to make you feel as if you're depressed, make you feel as if you're not enough, make you feel unmotivated, to cloud your mind and your judgment. These people have been doing magic to hold and restrict your finances as well. Overall, they have been trying to make your fucking life hard as fuck. So some of you guys may be seeing crows. Some of you guys may be seeing owls. You may be hearing or seeing these birds. It is an indication that divination and black magic is being done. Some of you guys might have had hella flies around you. That is a sign that someone is getting readings done on you or they're pulling cards on you. These practitioners are about to die if they are self-practicing. Some of these people, the people that they have been going to for this magic, are experiencing death in their life, and they may even be dying. So after these deaths, like I said, there will be a major transformation. Some of you guys might be seeing 444 a lot, which indicates things are about to go in your favor. You are on the right path, and life is about to take place. Divine timing is taking place. 555, which represents the change that is coming in your life. 888, which represents the abundance that you are about to come into, be it an abundance of healing, an abundance of love, an abundance of gratitude, an abundance in finances. And 999, for these cycles are about to be over. All right, so the Hawk represents valuable lessons that the universe is trying to teach you. Some of you guys, the universe is most definitely trying to teach you about being careful who you trust. Some of you guys, after situations happen, you probably had a thought in your mind like, well, I shouldn't have been doing this. Well, lesson learned. I know not to do this anymore. I know for me, the lesson was to, you know, it does not matter how long you've known somebody. Sometimes you still do not know that person. Just because a person verbally or openly supports you does not mean that they have it in their heart to really support you. All right, so the Hawk also represents sharpening your focus. Some of you guys need to get rid of distractions around you so that you can really tune into your intuition. If there is drama going on, if there is people that distract you, people always want to gossip, people always want to just do other shit besides boss the fuck up, heal, and focus on yourself, you need to get them people away from you. The Hawk also represents clarity. It also represents intuitive decision making. So this is clarity coming to a lot of you guys on things that you have wondered about. Those repetitive thoughts that you have been getting, those are not just random fucking thoughts. Those are downloads. Those are your spirit guides talking to you. That is God talking to you, letting you know what's going on. Stop doubting that. Some of you guys need to use your intuition to make decisions. That's why you need to clear your intuition, clear your energy, because there will be some events coming to you. These people are fucking mad that a lot of you guys are finding out what the fuck they are doing. These people are mad because whatever magic they have been doing is not working no more. This shit is starting to backfire. So at this point, a lot of these people are going to be desperate. You will be witnessing people lose their fucking mind. You will be witnessing people just wanting conflict. Very aggressive for no fucking reason. These people are under judgment. You need to clear your intuition so that you can fully use it to move about life moving forward. The Hawk also represents protection. That was that bush of cardinals that I seen. A lot of you guys, your ancestors are around you. Your guides are making their presence known. Some of you guys are seeing orbs. You guys are seeing white blurs. Your eyes might be feeling like they're blurry, but there's nothing in your fucking eye. Some of you guys might be feeling like it's someone behind you, on the side of you, in front of you. Some of you guys might be seeing shadows. Some of you guys might just be seeing shit. Y'all might even be seeing these people in full form. They are around you. They letting you know that you are protected. Some of the cardinals that I seen, they were like in trees and shit, like pushed back. But when I looked at them and tried to take a picture, they would fly off. Your ancestors, some of you guys stop sharing when you have dreams about passed over loved ones, because you are giving the enemy a one up that they are being watched. All right. Angel number 212. Trust yourself and your abilities. Stop doubting your intuition. You are not crazy. Some of you guys need to trust that gut feeling. You're not fucking crazy. You are intuitive. You are connected. You are divine. You are chosen. You get messages. You're not crazy. Some of you guys have karmic people around you. Them motherfuckers is crazy. Them motherfuckers make shit up in their head. And they hate the fact that you are intuitive and that you are connected enough to receive divine guidance and messages. Fuck the position or the title that people have held in your life. Hold them accountable for their actions. Judge them not based off the time that y'all have had in these relationships or how much shit you went through with them. Judge these people based off their intentions. Pay attention to the energy that you feel when you are around these fucking people. If you feel anxious, if you feel like they're hiding something, if you feel like they're trying to manipulate you, if you feel like they are trying to purposely steer you into bad situations, trust that shit. Some of you guys with your ancestors, your guides, your passed over loved ones, you might be seeing their birthdays. You might be seeing the telephone numbers that they've had. You might be seeing their name. You might be seeing, you could even be smelling a scent that they used to like. If they used to smoke cigarettes, they had a certain scent about themselves. You might be seeing these people in your dreams. You might wake up and remember the dreams. You might wake up and not remember the dreams, but just know that you feel warm. You wake up feeling loved. You wake up feeling emotional and don't know why. They're letting you know, I'm here. They stepping for y'all. That was a lot. All right, now I was picking up my cards and two fell out. Forgiveness and angel of the universe. Forgiveness. Some of you guys need to forgive, whether it be yourself, whether it be someone that has passed, whether it be someone in your life, whether it be someone that has done you wrong, you feel like you did not deserve it. You need to wrap that shit up. There are people in your life who have new beginnings of fucking karma because they could not fucking forgive. They thought they had blessings coming. They about to walk into fucking karma because they chose not to forgive. They chose to be fucking spiteful. You wrap that shit up and forgive these people. Holding on to anger is like grasping a hot coal with the intent of throwing it at someone else. You are the one who gets burned. Some of these fucking people don't even know. They were hurting themselves in the process of trying to hurt you. I had a dream a few nights ago of someone. I was in an apartment with them, and as soon as I walked through the door, they had a gun to my face. As soon as this person tried to shoot me, the gun jammed. This person looked fucking petrified. Then I was laughing as I took the gun, and I ended up shooting them 3 times. Once in the arm, twice in the leg. That only told me the things that people have done to try to hurt me is only going to hurt themselves. And the things that these people have done to you in attempts to hurt you, 11-11, they thought that shit was funny. All these people are shocked now because they seeing they only hurt them fucking selves. By practicing forgiveness, you can find new meaning to life's worst events. As love and compassion combine in the sacred space of the heart, they are released as a powerful energy. And everything changes. All possibilities again become open to you. Fuck what they did to you. I'm not saying fuck it as in like let them hold us back, but fuck it. You can't change people. Misery loves company. A miserable person wants other people to be miserable so they can have some type of person to relate to. They want somebody to relate to. Practice forgiveness so you can let their ass go. Take that pain from that situation and put it into something productive. Some of you guys have these fucking gifts that y'all are sitting on. God gives you talent so you never have to work for somebody else. When you go to a job, I'm not saying it's not a good thing to work a job because we got fucking bills to pay. Age number 12-12. But what I'm saying is, think about it. When you go to your job, you are giving your energy to support somebody else's talent, somebody else's dream. So why not start to invest in your own? The angel of the universe, you are being encouraged to expand your thinking. 222. Some of you guys need to stop looking at the situation and look at the lesson behind it. Look at how you can take this situation and alchemize it. Look at how you could take the pain and turn it into your passion. Take that passion and turn it into a profit. Let's see. We're going to get some cards. What's going on with this message with my collective? What is this message, Holy Spirit? Give me some cards. What's going on with this situation? What is going on with this situation, Holy Spirit? Some of y'all need to be careful. Some of y'all got some people around you that y'all thought really fucking had love for y'all. And behind the scenes, they are preparing things for you to not go in your favor. These have been people that have been wishing bad on you. People that have been acting like they really think about you. Yeah, people that don't want you to follow your dreams. Hermit card. Page of Cups in reverse. Yes. Some of y'all have people that literally sit up and think about ways so they can block you from following your dreams. Yes. Most definitely. Hermit card. And then the issue. Queen of Pentacles. Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn energy. However, these people do not want you to put effort into anything because they scared that you're going to take the fuck off. So they sitting up thinking about how they could stop you before you take off. These people know that you are coming into balance. You are coming into abundance. You are coming into your own. They don't want you to go into business with you. So they want you to be blocked off. These people don't want you thinking about your future. They want you to stay stuck in the fucking past. Clarify this, Queen of Swords. Yes. These people, they want you, if you do come into your own, they want you to think that they've been there for you since day one. Y'all have people trying to piggyback off y'all. What's this Hierophant in reverse? They don't want you to take action about biz. They don't want you to take action in regards to love. They want you to go back to things that did not serve you. to slow up your energy so that you do not invest in what it is that is for you. They want you to be in despair. When they see that you're changing your outlook and that you're being more positive, they don't like that. They don't like that. They don't want you to do that. They don't want you to be content with being by yourself. They want you to be struggling. They know that you're meant to be abundant. You are meant to be wealthy. They want you to be struggling. But the wheel of fortune is turning. You are coming out of confusion in regards to these things. I feel like I also have someone coming out of confusion in regards to who they have feelings for. Some of these people have blocked connections for you guys. Some of these people have just blocked you from even discovering what it is that you love. It don't even have to be a person. These people do not want you to follow your passions. They don't want you to figure out what it is that you love to do. They want you to be focused on partying. They want you to be focused on not learning your fucking lessons. They don't want you to heal. They want you to be stuck in failure. Some of these people don't even want you to have children. They don't want you to bear children. They don't want you to invest in your child could be your business. They don't want you to invest in your business because they know it's going to bring profit. Yeah. These people, people are liars. They are deceitful. These are people that can't heal from their own problems, so they don't want you to heal from shit. They want to be able to hit you up and talk about, oh, did you see what X, Y, and Z put on their page? Oh, well, I just can't believe X, Y, and Z did you like that. Yeah, that's just like my X, Y, and Z. They doing me the same way. Don't partake in that low vibrational shit. They want you to be emotional as fuck so you can act off impulse. It makes them happy when you act off impulse. They want you to cheat so that you can be in despair about your fucking partnership ending. They don't want you to come out of toxic energy. They want you to go back to it. They want you to be liars. They want you to be manipulative. A lot of you guys have learned. Y'all know better. Y'all used to be like that, but y'all learned and y'all know better now. And do you know what that means? When you know better, you are held accountable for your fucking actions. Yeah, but there was a tower. That was a tower. And what's this tower? They don't want you to go after new ventures. A tower definitely has hit. These people are seeing. The energy that they put out is what the fuck they getting back. But they gonna get it back tenfold. Some of these people are 100-fold. Let's see. Give me a few cards, Holy Spirit. Give me a few cards. What is the energy behind this? What is the energy behind what is going on with this collective? Some of y'all just need to choose to forgive these people. Instead of saying like, oh, this bitch did this, this motherfucker did this. Forgive them. For they didn't know no better. You know better. I actually feel bad for some of these people. Your mind is so small. So fucking small that instead of focusing on your own gifts, your own talents, your own life, you want to focus on stopping somebody. You want to focus on watching the motherfucker and watching their next move. Some of these people have been getting readings to manipulate the situations that came out yesterday in the reading. They've been getting readings to try to control your fucking destiny. I know people like that. They get readings, and when the reading is done, they leave that reading and they try to go change destiny. They try to go change energy. Even though they said, well, this is going to happen, I'm going to try to not do this so this don't happen. You can't do that. What's meant to happen is meant to fucking happen. What is the energy? Yeah. Somebody was trying to prevent somebody's change. They didn't want them to go on a fucking journey. But a false person has been cut off. Yeah, a false person has been cut off. Somebody was trying to block somebody's great fucking fortune. Yeah. Chow. Let's see. Where my other cards at? All right, so who is this that my collective needs to forgive? I'm gonna get a few situations, a few scenarios. We at 19 minutes. Okay. It's a false person. Some of y'all cut somebody out that was false. Very fucking false. This person will watch you and not speak. This person will fucking lurk on your fuck. If you have social media, they lurk on your social media. They watch you. They watch your family. They watch your kids. Y'all cut this person off. This person is not held in high honor. So they wanted you to be looked at as if you weren't held in high honor as well. Yeah. Distant horizons. privileged lady in reverse. They wanted you in the long run to be looked at as a fraud. They wanted you not to be, they knew you were privileged. They feel like you're privileged. If I'm not mistaken, privilege means that you get like a silver spoon. No. Shit that y'all got, these people look at you like, oh, everything comes to them naturally. Everything comes to them. They don't see the struggle behind how the fuck you got what the fuck you got. They don't see when you crying that fucking night because you don't know how shit is going to turn out, but you got faith that God is going to work things out for you. They don't see what you're doing behind the scenes. Them long nights and early mornings, they don't see all of that. They just feel like you're fucking privileged. They want you to hurt. They want you to be in pain. It was a community behind this. Some of you guys need to forgive a fucking community. It was quite a few people that was trying to make people look at y'all in a light that was not y'all. Yeah. Some of y'all too, these people were trying to prevent y'all from having kids or trying to get your kids taken away. Or they were just trying to do something in regards to a child, losing a fucking child. Immature people. They were trying to prevent change in your life when they should have been focused on changing theirs. Some of these people were trying to come out of poverty by attaching themselves to people, making it seem like they were very loyal to these people. When all along, they just knew this person had destiny of being fucking wealthy. They knew this person had destiny of being wealthy. So they were trying to act like they were so supportive. Yeah, lovers. Wealthy man in reverse. Sudden wealth. Some of these people are even trying to get in tune with your counterpart. Your counterpart might be a little, you know, might be eating, you know, noodles and tap water every night right now. But baby, they destined to come into sudden wealth. These people knew that. Yeah, they know this person wasn't their official self. So I feel like these people, they probably tried to halt you or your person's healing. Because they did not want you or your person to come into this wealth. They wanted it to be a crab in a buckle. Crab in a buckle. Ooh, child. Crab in a bucket type thing. But you and your person came through whatever the fuck you was going through. And when they seen that y'all was moving towards that sudden wealth, at this point, if they couldn't beat you, they want to fucking join you. A false person. This person could have been going through health issues. You or your person could have been going through health issues. This person was sitting back watching because they probably the reason why this shit was happening. This false person could have also been going through health issues and it was part of their motherfucking karma. I feel like God was giving them warnings. Father, forgive me for cursing and using your name. But this person was getting warnings. This person got sick before. They got sick and it was temporary. They came from it. That was the universe warning them. You keep doing what you're doing, this shit gonna be permanent. What does my collector need to expand their mind on? We're going to get ready to wrap this up. So I didn't mean for this to be this long. Distant horizons. Focus on the future. Stop worrying. Stop worrying about if people don't hold you in high honor. Yeah. Stop expecting a change or stop expecting something to not change with somebody. If you love somebody, think the best for it. Only thing that can happen is either it manifests or it does not. It's either or, but stop worrying. Stop worrying about how people view you. Stop worrying about what people motherfucking trying to do. Because just know you are protected. Stop worrying about if somebody's going to change or not. All you can do is pray on it. These people want you to manifest problems into your life. They want you to be worried. They don't want you. They know if you think about, some of these people know that y'all so fucking powerful. Whatever you think about is what manifests in your life. So they try to do reverse psychology. They wanted you to manifest problems. But the issue is a message. Some of you guys, these motherfuckers is worried about you getting married. For what? I do not fucking know. Lovers, yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. This person wanted whoever you guys were dealing with to stay in their unofficial self. Because they didn't want them to go on a pathway. Some of y'all could have been dealing with an immature man, immature woman. This person is scared that if this person marries you, it's going to be lights out for them. There's not hiring sign in the back. It might be hard for these people to even find fucking jobs. Some of these people are about to be put the fuck out. They're about to be on the fucking streets. Mm-hmm. This false person was trying to avoid court. They were trying to switch destinies. Courthouse, courtship. These bitches were trying to switch destinies with you. They didn't want to be deemed as the false person. They wanted you to be deemed as the false person. So instead of them going to the courthouse, they'd be going to a courtship. Because they knew you were destined for courtship. They wanted you to have the issues that they were having. That shit about to fucking backfire. Yeah, it's an end for this shit. Coughing. Yeah. Somebody's about to die from bad health. And I feel like it's this bad fucking person. It's this fucking false fucking person. It's this false fucking person. Somebody's about to pass away from bad health. Let's see. If it's not this person, for some I'm hearing what they did is so motherfucking bad. Death would be too easy. So it's going to be the death of somebody that they really fucking love. So they can live in torment. Yeah, they weren't concerned when they was causing problems in your life. They wasn't concerned about balancing your life. Yeah. Some of y'all about to get a message as well about unexpected income. It's going to be a pretty little fucking penny too. It just took for y'all to cut somebody the fuck out before this money came in. Hoo-wee. Yeah. Now, it's a main male. Could be a main female that's in fucking despair about something. What the fuck is they in despair about? About a courtship. Yeah, they feel like they going through judgment for this shit. Yeah, they feel like they going through judgment. Somebody is seeing it. Somebody purposely blocked something for somebody. And somebody's seeing that shit clearly. Some of y'all about to come with some money. You know, whether it's tough, people got free will. Whether you and your person coming to this unexpected income together, which y'all was destined, I feel like, too. Whether y'all do it or not, this person has free will. If they don't get that shit together, you're going to get it regardless. What's meant for you is for you. What's for you is for fucking you. Yeah. Not somebody worried about death. It's somebody, it's a main male out here that's worried about dying. This man is worried about dying. This person could even be worrying about the death of a relationship. Yeah. Death or imprisonment. This person has three choices. This person could have three options as well. One option will lead them to death. One option will lead their ass to prison. And one option will lead them to a courtship. What's this coffin card? Yeah. Now, what's crazy? The option with death, whoever they're dealing with that will lead them to death in this for new beginnings, somebody thought that they would be getting, I'm hearing like reparations, some type of income, alimony, spousal support, something. Somebody thought that if they just got this masculine out the fucking way, that they would get the sudden wealth. They would come up off this person. This masculine could be coming into money. And this person knows that. But they don't want them to know that. Whoever they dealing with don't want this person to know they got money coming. So they figure if they just take this man out, all that shit'll go to them. What's his imprisonment card? Yeah. This option that will lead them to imprisonment, they know this man is wealthy. Could have been put into bad health by a lover. Yeah. Somebody could even get married behind the scenes, didn't tell their family. Yeah, planned a whole life with this person. Never thought that this person would set them up. Somebody could have been trying to set this person up while they were sick to get arrested, to go to jail, to go to prison. Snitch energy, it's a rat right here. Somebody tried to set somebody up to have them locked up so they would not have access to their funds. And they tricked this person into marriage so that they can control their funds. This person planned on leaving this person high and fucking dry. Because this was going to be this person's last strike. Option with courtship. Yeah. It was a main female. Somebody's family could have wanted this person to get rid of them. Family room reverse. This person could not like somebody's family. There's some type of message. Yeah, wealthy man. This man could have got news while with this person that he was coming into wealth, but his health started acting up. He started seeing no change in his motherfucking health because of an immature woman outside of the situation. Somebody was playing off the fact that this masculine was immature. They were tired of working, and they knew that this man was coming into sudden wealth. So they wanted this man to get rid of the main fucking female. Yeah. Because whoever the fuck this unofficial person was, they were in poverty. And they wanted to come out of that shit. They were tired of working, toil and labor in reverse. They wanted a gift. A gift that was not fucking theirs. They didn't think they'd be going through fucking judgment for that shit. This person could have lost a child. This person could have been pregnant and lost a child for trying to steal something, and they can't steal it. Yeah, now they're going to be in despair. It's going to be a community of people that fucking go to jail behind this shit. Let's get some advice. I'm going to wrap this up because I need a coffee. What is the advice for this collective? What seems an injustice was actually a blessing. What you see as somebody doing you wrong as fuck, just know. You're not going to go through no trials without a reward at the end. You're just not. You're being encouraged to take a leading role in your current situation because you are the god or the goddess of sacred power. It's time for you to summon your power. It's time for you. It's time for war. It's time. I don't know if I can say that, but it's time. Metaphorically speaking, it's motherfucking time. It is a spiritual WAR going on. Stay tough, not say that shit again. It is a spiritual WAR going on. Your efforts, determination, and perseverance have paid off. Honor and give thanks for the blessings you about to receive. Some of y'all about to come into some money. Y'all about to come into some money. And it's going to help y'all be able to do what it is that you need to do moving forward. What is the advice for this collective? Choose to forgive these people. Choose to forgive them. I forgive myself for being critical of my mother. Until today, you may have been harboring judgments or negative opinions about your mother in a way that she did not or did mother you. Just for today, forgive yourself for judging your mother for being who she simply was. Some of you guys need to forgive your mother. Forgiveness. You need to forgive your mother. She was who she was. All we can do is accept that and just make better decisions on our behalf. I take the time to deal with unpleasant memories. You may not have realized that you were angry, even understood why. Set the intention to heal any unexpressed anger that may be present in your life. Some of you guys need to tell these people that have hurt you that you have fucking hurt me. Get that shit off your spirit. Lighten the load on your spirit. Ask the Holy Spirit to transform that anger into passion for life. Share your love with God. You might be feeling overwhelmed from trying to do everything on your own, but ask God to help ease some of your burdens. All y'all got to do is ask God. Talk to God. Build a relationship with him. Just go to him like he no genie. Build a relationship with him. I have more than enough of what it takes to make it through rough times and tight places. You may have thought that what happens to you and around you determines the nature of who you are. But today, allow faith, joy, patience, and peace to be the character building tools that determine your approach to the experiences in life. Like I said, some of y'all had people around y'all purposely making shit happen. They were purposely making shit happen to make you feel like this is what the fuck you deserve. This is what the fuck you're going to live. No, I accept that things are the way that they need to be. Accept that you are perfect just how you are. So thank y'all for tuning in. I greatly appreciate that. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell if this is your story. And yes. And I will always love you.
That is, bitch. I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am that bitch, yeah. I am gonna go get that bag, and I am not gonna take your shit. I am protected, well respected, I'm a queen, I'm a dream, yeah. I do what I wanna do, and I'm who I wanna be.